Y'all on board. Young man couldn't leave that shore. Had the life they made for him till he seeked out more. Boat ride, couldn't see that storm. He'll get up though, he know he close. It's too late to jump ship. Aw damn, aw damn, you that motherfucker shit. I know, this shit became a trip, Cabo. Up in the womb, but you can feel it when I kick it, I know. And you too must be rocking with Lil Dicky Bono. It's like I hit the lotto, I had to hit the Waldo. I couldn't see it for a minute, shit was hitting Waldo. They treat it like I'm going crazy, I'm just playing, I don't. It's just, I know, it's just, I know. I saw the world like, hold up, damn near faking on the side. Let me take you on the ride, let me tell you about the one that couldn't take the 9 to 5. Used to take the 9 to 5, down to Richmond bumping Jigga up in the ride. Used to think along the drive about my drive. Used to wonder why, used to wonder when the world will see me like I'm seeing mine. Used to whine, used to wanna shine, used to wanna dine. Used to talk to bitches in my mind when they been walking by. Girl, what's happening? Girl, what's happening? I ain't really about to get involved, that's what's happening. Everything I knew was unevolved like a Baptist. Laying on my mattress, praying I could have this. And now when I get Tinder matches, they think they been catfish. Now I be controlling how we living like a fascist. Now I got this weight up off my shoulders like a strapless. Remember this shit was hapless.
Remember the day it happened.
Oh, you the shit, day. You been killing everything you did. Got the whole world talking all about what you did. Got your old girl talking all about what you is. Got your old world looking like it's his.
I've been fucking for the fuck of it. And one of them bitches I've been fucking with been wondering how I could work this much and stomach it. She wonders what I want from it. I said, we don't gotta get into it. She like, nah, just do it. She a psychology student. She always following up. Find a guy to be amusing as fuck. Usually I'll answer her truthfully, but truthfully I'm unusually used to being unusually good at internalizing when music is not provided. But I'll humor ho. Ask her if she ever saw the Truman Show. She like, yeah. I'm like, well, when I saw that shit, I was convinced I was living like Jim. A similar situation where I was the basis of everyone's entertainment. Like really up in the basement talking to y'all in the mirror, because I thought that Lil David was some American hero. I know it's selfish and all, but I just felt it's my call. I was a 10-year-old then, by 2010 I was wrong. I'm like, aw damn, you the motherfucker though. I know, this shit became a trip, Cabo. Up in the womb, but you can feel it when I kick it, I know. And you too must be rocking with Lil Dicky Bono. It's like I hit the lotto, I had to hit the Waldo. I couldn't see it for a minute, shit was hitting Waldo. They treat it like I'm going crazy, I'm just playing, I don't. It's just, I know, it's just, I know. 23 bars up in my apartment, I am D-Bar. Gotta do this shit, I gotta recharge, but I gotta be smart. Moving up that ladder, company star, fuck it, that ain't nothing. I am the star, spitting like a retard. Work was like a prison, I'm just seeing bars. My boss was all up in my camp, but I'm just seeing Lars. I've been a heavyweight Muhammad Ali, and if he can mold that out of clay, then I can turn to Lil D. So now I'm snapping like I'm Truman, but off and on, there's always something in the way. I should be off and gone. Girl, I'm sorry if this dragon, I just need you to imagine being stuck up on the land without a captain. When every day is average, and every day you're feeling like a captive, and feeling like something's seriously lacking. And then you fear what could happen if you just leave it on the table like napkins. But yo, you really fearing hitting them rappers and leaving everything behind, cause you don't know what that horizon brings. But girl, you gotta know what kind of fish you is. Survival instinct, kick to sink or swim. I flip the playlist, quit my day gig now. I'm on a boat, lonely island, irony. And you still been trying to figure how I work this tirelessly. But girl, this is everything I've thought. This for everything I've fought. This for who I am to me becomes to y'all. Go. They telling me no, but I just be telling them yeah. Go. I just be telling them yeah. Go. I just be telling them yeah. Tell them I'm gone. Yeah. I just pretend I ain't scared. Go. Don't even know if it's there. Go. Don't even know if I care. Cause girl, this is Truman approaching the wall. Until I'm me, I am nothing at all. Until I'm free, I will not see beyond. I had to be who I was all along, ayy. I think I might have broke it down. Hopping on the fucking steps like ain't no one round. Open up that door, you bet, ship it going down. Guess the only thing that's left is to take a bow. Aw damn, you that motherfucking shit. I know, this shit became a trip, Cabo. Up in the womb, but you can feel it when I kick it, I know. And you too must be rocking with Lil Dicky Bono. It's like I hit the lotto, I had to hit the wall though. I couldn't see it for a minute, shit was hitting wall. They treat it like I'm going crazy, I'm just praying I don't. It's just, I know, it's just, I know. Fuck, that felt good. Well, that's all I got. The show is over as they say. Honestly, I just think that part in the Truman Show where his boat hits the wall, is really the exact moment that I'm at in my own life right now. Metaphorically, of course. And I think I'm ready for it. Like, I've been thinking about it, I think I'm ready. I mean, if I'm being completely transparent with y'all, like, my lifestyle hasn't really changed that much, you know, considering where I think I'm at musically. Like, I'm still at the point right now where pretty much any bitch that tweets at me anything remotely flirtatious, I have seen not just one of your pictures, I've seen the entire catalog. That's the type of shit that's going down over here right now, so I am definitely ready for that next step, you know what I'm saying? I think it's close, too. I think it's close, like, Diddy tweeted about me, you know, that I don't know if he handles his own Twitter. I would assume he probably doesn't, actually. But, like, I'm so confident that I feel as though, like, me and Diddy will have a moment just about this outro, like, where we're both sitting next to each other, smoking cigars, and being like, hey, remember when you said that shit on that outro? Like, and I'm like, yeah, this is the exact moment I did that for, you know what I'm saying? Bring the beat back up. I don't know why. Keep, like, loop everything. I want to be talking for minutes, yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like, shout out my MacBook Pro. Had that shit since 09. I made my first song ever on it. Like, when I called myself Lil Dicky, I made my, like, fucking album songs on that shit. We survived, baby. Shout out Allen Iverson, Larry David, Will Smith, and Kobe Bryant for making me the man that I am today, both on and off the court. Shout out my mother, what a great woman. She's so mad that I recorded these conversations. She honestly went crazy. It took so much convincing to allow this. But she's awesome, she's adapting to the rap game, as we all are. Look, I just wanna get this to a place where I can sell TMZ pictures of my actual asshole. You know? I think that'd be such a feat if I could actually create like an alt alias and sell TMZ pictures of my own asshole, like profit off of that. That I would totally do it. I don't know why Seth Rogen's not already doing it. And I'm seeing the signs that it's not, that I think I'm seeing the signs. I hope I am. If I'm really just misreading all these signs, then I am 100% gonna have like a legitimate nervous breakdown at some point very soon. So we'll find out about that. But I see some signs, like I really am not fucking that much. But like the other day I did fuck a bitch to music. Like I fucked a bitch to some Miguel. And that's kind of new for me if I'm being real. Like I had never actually done it before. But I was feeling like on some king shit, you know what I'm saying? So I was like, man, I'm gonna fuck this bitch to some Miguel right now. Actually, to be completely real with you, I will never fuck a girl to music again. I found the whole thing to feel like completely cliche. Like, I don't need my emotions dictated to me by, like, music. It makes me feel like I'm in, like, a TV scene. Takes all the, like, realness out of the moment for me. Like, I actually was actually super weirded out by it. So, but still, like, I am about to let my hair down and I don't know, I just feel like it's all coming. I feel like I'm literally, like, about to find out about everything. And it's exciting. And I had pink eye last week. And I remember thinking as I like was like real down, because I was like trying to keep recording and shit, but I was thinking like, what would Michael Jordan do? And he would play through the pink eye. So that's why I'm in here. I'm still not fully recovered, you know what I'm saying? I'm definitely clearing up. Like, it's totally on the upswing, but I just want you to know I did record this shit through pink eye. Alright, I could talk for fucking years, legitimate years. This is an outro to an album. You see how long I talk on the outros of songs, but goddamn. Look, I need to get out of here. I'm about to go take a Khalifa, rest up. That's right, I did invent that phrase just there, take a Khalifa. You know what I'm saying? I also invented That's What She Said, but I get no credit for it. Shout out to dickheads, obviously. Funding this whole operation. What you know about a Kickstarter, man? What you know about the best fans in the world? Seriously. Thank you guys, I appreciate it. Honestly, you made my dreams come true, and that's fact. Couldn't have done this without y'all. I'd like to shout out my dick. I know, you know, we haven't had the smoothest relationship, but I feel as though by kind of putting our issues out there, like, we have become something bigger than we could have been otherwise. And hopefully soon you will be rewarded for your patience. And I will be rewarded for my patience. And I respect you. I'd like to shout out my brain. My brain got the hardest verse on the whole goddamn album. I hope my brain starts getting some feature looks. but he don't just hop on shit. Fuck, I got nothing left. I'm out, I'm a professional rapper. Long live LD, and in case I don't see ya, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.